Scientists have discovered the world's first hybrid shark. And they found the shark right off Australia. Uh-huh. And basically, it's the Australian black-tip shark that's mating with the common black-tip. The Australian black-tip shark lives in warmer waters. The common black-tip lives in cooler waters. So scientists are thinking that they're mating in order to reproduce and create other little sharks that can live in colder temperatures.
Okay, did you get all that? All right, so basically what happens, the Australian black-tip shark is in waters that are much colder than it's supposed to be in, and they're like, what?
You don't know that, man.
They're like, what are you doing in there, right? And it turns out he has evolved, right? He or she, or both, obviously, have evolved because of possibly global warming. Mm-hmm. Because the temperatures are fluctuating in the water, and so it's actually climate change. Mm-hmm. And because of that change, now the Australian black tip has to live in colder water, so it is mutated so that it is living in the colder water, which I think is like the coolest thing ever. I mean, climate change part of it sucks, obviously.
Right.
But evolution, man, can't beat it.
I just think that for the first time, liberals should just be quiet about climate change. Because obviously we're going to adapt, we're going to evolve, and everything's going to be okay.
The problem is, if we evolve, we will no longer be humans. Okay. I mean, we might be humans in a different way. We might have six arms or three eyes or something. But I doubt that's the way it's going to go. Here we go, Cenk talking about evolution. Look, you can begin to see the effects throughout the world. But what I love about the evolution stories is that the people who deny evolution. So, but wait, it just happened to the shark. We just saw it, right? Like, we're documenting it as we speak, right? This is where they used to be. This is where they are now. It's a new hybrid version. Like, yeah. Well, you know what? God probably decided that, I feel like doing a hybrid version of the Australian black-tip shark so that he can live in colder water. Boom, make it happen. Same reason we got the Toyota Prius. God was in a mood to create a hybrid version of the Toyota.
All right, let me point out a couple other things about this story. Uh-huh. So what the scientists found was that 20% of the black tip population in this particular area right off of Australia are the hybrid sharks, right? So right now they're trying to figure out whether or not this is something that has occurred recently or if it's happened for a while and they've just discovered it now. Mm-hmm. Okay, and they're not concluding that this is because of evolution, this is because of climate change. Okay,
so what?
Yeah, so there are no definitive answers yet. But I mean, I think it does make sense, especially since these sharks, the hybrid shark, is better suited to live in colder temperatures.
When they asked the hybrid shark, hey, have you evolved? He said,
I have never seen you, and you've never seen me.
So they said, wow, so you are a hybrid we haven't seen before. And he said,
you don't know me. And I don't know you.
Mr. Powers, you'll notice that all of the sharks have laser beams attached to their heads. I figure every creature deserves a warm meal.
You see, it proves it. Look, I don't want anybody to get the wrong impression that I'm like, it's definitely because of climate change and it's definitely evolution. We're saying, obviously, it's possible given the circumstances.
The way evolution works, for people who don't know, it's not like because there's warmer water, all of a sudden the sharks that are alive become evolved to live in that condition. What happens is they all die out. And then the ones who have a special mutation that can tolerate the colder temperatures, they survive.
So if humans were to evolve, that would mean that we would all die. And the ones that mutated to have the six arms or maybe had more hair or whatever could survive warmer or colder temperatures, depending on how the climate change happened, that new species would survive. Mm-hmm. So.